Hi guys, and welcome back to Mchiki series. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your support. If you're new to this channel, you might consider subscribing
by clicking on the red button on your right, which says subscribe. Also hit the bell icon. That way you get notification whenever I upload a new video.
In today's video, I'll be sharing my struggles and experiences of buying a house in Abuja and how Nigerian Labour Congress and Kriston Lally EPC scammed us. I'm making this video not to scare anybody from investing in property in Nigeria, but just to make you to be more careful, to inform you so that you don't think because government establishment is involved that there is no fraud, or because a company is registered that means there will be no fraud. You have to mount your guards and investigate things properly yourself. Abuja is the administrative and political capital of Nigeria, and it's one of the fastest growing cities in Africa, which means that a lot of people are coming into the city for contracts, for business, and even for jobs. And the city is not too big. They have a lot of people living in the suburb. The heart of the city is very expensive, with lots of unoccupied buildings. An average civil servant can barely pay a rent in the heart of Wuse, Maitama, or Asokoro. Most people live in Nyanya and Maraba and commute to work every day. Some are also in Kubu, Agogolada, or Lube, and this makes it very important for one to buy his or her own house, or better still, buy a land and erect their own structure. A decent two-bedroom apartment in Maitama, Asokoro can go as high as 2.5 million naira, which is approximately $7,000 in a year. While one-bedroom apartment in the same Maitama Asokoro goes for 1.5 million naira, approximately $4,000 per annum. One bedroom, I mean, is one room and one parlor. So the question remains, how can one raise some funds to pay off for this property? We all know that buying a house is not a walk in the park. You need to save for some months. Some people save over the years to be able to pay off for the cost of a property. And this made the Nigerian workers to jump on the offer of Nigerian Labour Congress and Kriston Lally EPC affordable housing scheme. And this all started on the 1st of May 2013. During Workers' Day celebration, Nigerian Labour Congress, which is the labour union, under the leadership of Abdul Wahid Omar, announced their desire to construct 300,000 housing units nationwide in collaboration with a real estate developer, Kriston Lally EPC, to provide affordable housing scheme to Nigerian workers. Actually, it was an interesting offer with an initial payment of 10% of the value of any house of your choice, with the keys to the new house handed to you after 1 year, while you settle in to pay off the outstanding balance spread over 2 to 15 years, with 2% interest rate per annum. There are different houses ranging from 1-bedroom apartment to 4-bedroom bungalow, and different house types attract different price tag. The plan was that phase one of the project, comprising of 100,000 housing units, to be completed by June 2014, for the owner to take possession by latest December 2014, and another 200,000 housing units to be delivered on or before June 30, 2015. So most workers saw it as an opportunity, as an irresistible offer, whereby you have opportunity of living in your own house while you pay off the mortgage at 2% interest.
Affordable housing is a major challenge confronting workers in the urban areas, where many people live in slums, as the nation struggles with about 40 million housing deficit. In April 2013, the Nigerian Labour Congress signed an MOU with Kriston Lally to provide 10,000 housing units for workers to ease housing problems. Thousands subscribed by contributing 10% equity, which qualified them to own their houses, while the remaining balance would be spread through mortgage.
However, I never got to hear this until in October 2013, when my colleague brought their flyers to the office. Despite that, I did not take it serious till on this fateful day I was driving back from work. I had the advert on Cool FM signed by Nigerian Labour Congress. At the mention of the labour union, I felt there would be no way it would be a scam, and I decided to give it a try. And little did I know it was an organized scam. The next day, on my way back to work, I stopped at Zenith Bank and paid non-refundable amount of 5,000 naira into NLC Kriston Lally EPC account for my personal identification number. They call it PIN number. Using my PIN number, I carefully filled an online subscription form on their website, requesting for a 3-bedroom detached bungalow at a pool costing a total of 8.3 million naira. But on the submission of the form, I paid 10% of the total cost, which is 832,611 naira, to the same Zenith Bank account. With the teller, I proceeded to Kriston Lally EPC office on number 46 Lobito Crescent at Wuse 2, Abuja. where I was issued with an official receipt and an invoice was also issued for the balance of the 90% with a repayment chart, endorsement form, an offer letter, and a formal contract as a subscriber. Some of the subscribers interested in viewing the plot of land were accompanied by Lally APC contractor for viewing over the weekend. However, this land were never approved by Federal Capital Development Authority, FCDM. The response from prospective subscribers were overwhelming, and there was oversubscription while Kriston Lally was busy directing the funds to his private account rather than the joint Zenith Bank account advertised by NLC and we use for the registration. After over a year and 4 months, neither the house nor the money was forthcoming, and the hope of thousands of subscribers of having roof over their heads were shattered. That was when we knew that it was a sham. Some subscribers started demanding for refunds of their deposit following the delay for construction to commence.
2 years down the line, no land, houses, or refund has been made to workers, which prompted recent protests during every activity of NLC, particularly now that new labor leaders are expected to emerge.
It is unbelievable that Nigerian Labour Congress, that is supposed to be an advocate of justice, has now turned around to dupe Nigerian workers, to defraud Nigerian workers. All we are asking is that the projects they have invited Nigerian workers to subscribe to has failed. And for 2 years, we have been asking for a refund of our money. They are dodging.
Since the failure, accusations and counter-accusations now trailed NLC Kriston Lally over...
The demand for refunds intensified after it was found out in June 2014 that the Department of Development Control in FCDA did not give approval of the land purportedly allocated for the project. The attention of Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, was initially drawn to investigate the case by NLC General Secretary, Mr. Ozo Esom, but it appeared that they were not forthcoming. This made NLC approach the authorities of Directorate of State Security, DSS, which moved in, arrested and detained the managing director of Kriston Lally APC, Mr. Madawaki, for interrogation. At the end of the investigations, DSS reported clear cases of fraud against the company and its officials who agreed to pay back the money within 3 weeks. DSS also advised against a court case to avoid having subscribers wait a long time before getting a refund. Based on this, an agreement was signed by all parties, witnessed by two representatives of subscribers, and the secretariat was set up at Labour House to coordinate the process of refund. Notwithstanding the agreement, the managing director of Kriston Lally, in whose custody were instruments of transaction, including checkbooks and details of all dealings with bank, failed to show up, stalling the whole process of refund. After more than 3 weeks of no refund, Labour House was inundated by protests of anxious subscribers, and it didn't stop there. They went further to make a case in Abuja High Court.
Subscribers to the Nigeria Labour Congress housing scheme have given the NLC 3 weeks to refund their money, which they paid into an account approved by the labor union. Some of the subscribers protested at the Labour House in Abuja to demand an explanation for non-payment of their money months after the housing scheme was certified fraudulent. The Labour Congress in 2013 went into partnership with a private developer, Kriston Lally Nigeria Limited, to build 300,000 homes, 100,000 of which was to be commissioned in December this year. But the project is yet to take off, and the Labour Congress is alleging fraud by the developer, Kriston Lally Nigeria Limited.
The entrance to the premises of the Nigerian Labour Congress and other labour offices at the central area in Abuja, preventing anyone from going in or out. Workers from different organizations who subscribed to the NLC Kriston Lally Affordable Housing Scheme, launched by the Labour Congress on May Day 2013. Their demand is a refund of money they paid for the houses, which was to be delivered in December, but which has been shrouded in controversies amidst silence from the labor movement.
We are here because Nigerian Labour Congress has given us an assurance, the masses and the workers of this country, they are providing affordable housing scheme. Everything else seems to be a fraud. Nobody is talking to us. They are supposed to deliver this project at the end of this year. After we have
paid. They have collected our money. They have collected everything. They have given us offer. And we are over here.
We subscribe because there is NLC. I paid 10% of the amount, which amounted to 833,000 naira. Okay, mine is supposed to be 8.3 million naira. We want him before he leaves by Monday to refund our money. Not just our money, because this is 2 years. We are also interested in getting our interest.
After all said and done, the court declared that the action of NLC Kriston Lally breached the contractual agreement between both parties, saying that it was criminal and barbaric. Therefore, ordered that 10% of subscribers' deposit be refunded immediately without any deduction. But eventually, what did they do? NLC Kriston Lally went further to refund 85% of the subscribers' deposit while withholding 15%. I made a deposit of 832,000, but they refunded 707,000, which is difference of 15%, saying that 15% is for administrative charges. Remember, this money has been in the bank for over 2 years, and nobody was talking about the interest it must have generated. So when I complained of not having my full refund back, some people said to me that I was even lucky to have got 85% of the money. That some people who made such investment in the past lost everything and nobody was held accountable for the loss. At this point, I asked myself, so Nigeria has got to this level where we can do whatever we want and get away with it, and we cannot differentiate good from evil anymore. So my crime is that I went into contract with NLC Kriston Lally. The way we trivialize crime and fraud in Nigeria is very appalling and calls for the concern of the relevant authority. So much impunity in the system that some people think that the country belongs to only them and their family. So to me, I feel it's a well-organized and calculated scam. The NLC Kriston Lally housing scheme was terminated due to greed from NLC leadership, which made unrealistic demand from the initiator of the scheme, including that each member of the leadership of NLC under Abdul Wahid Omar be given a plot of land in Apo district in Abuja with 21 duplex executives. This is the height of disappointment that Nigerian Labour Congress will be involved in this kind of fraud to scam helpless workers, when it's clear that some of them mobilize their entire savings to pay for this initial deposit. If Nigerians cannot rely on credibility of NLC, which is supposed to be a labor union, then who will save the workers? And with this, I come to the end of this video. Let me know what you all think about this story. Are you one of the subscribers? Because I know the subscribers were well over 3,000. If you are one of us, leave your comment below. Let's keep the conversation going. Remember to share this video with friends and family because you don't know who you are saving. Thank you for watching and see you in my next one. Bye.